The Flutter team announced at the Google I/O event that was celebrated recently some web-related improvements that Flutter 3 brings. In the official keynote, they reported on the possibility of running Flutter in headless mode. And after that, they showed some performance tests that presumably increase Flutter's performance on the web by using the latest standards regarding image decoding. But is this true? And if it is, are the improvements they've made substantial enough for an end user to notice? Since I always like to check things out for myself, I've decided to run some performance tests comparing the difference between the previous version of Flutter, the version 2.10.5, with the new version 3 of Flutter. In this video, I'm going to show you the specific test that I have carried out, as well as the final result, so that you can see and judge for yourself how Flutter 3 performs on the web. In the official keynote, the Flutter team showed some screenshots in which a Flutter application appeared to load a bunch of GIFs. I have decided to follow the same methodology and take advantage of one of the open source projects that I already have created, in which the GIFI API is consumed and a lot of GIFs are displayed. I have cloned it and made some adjustments to it to add the web platform. After that, I execute it in the book, since Flutter Web does not support profile mode, and I have observed the frames per second indicator. Then, I have run the same test after upgrading to Flutter 3. I have repeated this set of tests on Windows, Mac, and Linux to see if there is a performance improvement on all or just some platforms. Before starting, I am going to show you the specific specs of the machines on which I am going to run the benchmarks. All the tests will be executed in Google Chrome, in its version 101. For the Windows and Linux tests, I will use a laptop configured with dual boot with the specifications that you can see on the screen. The tests on macOS will be executed with a MacBook Pro M1 from the year 2020. Starting with Windows 10, we can see the previous version of Flutter loading all the trending GIFs and reaching the figure of 35 frames per second. After upgrading to Flutter 3 and running the same test, I've seen the indicator go up around 39 frames per second, with which we can already see that in this first test, there is already an improvement over the previous version. I have repeated this same test with Chrome on my Mac 13-inch with an M1 chip. Here, we can see how it reaches 45 frames per second. And after upgrading, we can see how it goes up to almost 60 frames per second, a very substantial improvement and superior to that observed on Windows. Although we have to take into account that this is a different machine with different hardware. To finish, I have executed this benchmark on the same machine where I have Windows installed, but this time on another partition where I have Linux Mint mounted. 32 FPS, not bad, although it's lower than Windows. After upgrading, there is a small improvement up to 38 FPS. Now, I'm going to give you a summary of all of the tests. On Windows, we have seen how we went from around 35 FPS to 39. Which is an improvement of approximately 11%. On macOS is where I have seen the biggest difference, going from 45 frames per second to 58, which equates to a 28% improvement. Finally, on Linux, we have gone from about 32 FPS to 38, which represents an improvement of about 18%. By the way, keep in mind that these tests are being executed in debug mode, without minified code, so it is possible that the performance is higher in release mode. After having seen all this, I think we can say that there has certainly been a huge improvement in the performance of Flutter apps published in a browser. It remains to be seen if these improvements are also replicated in other browsers, such as Firefox or Safari. But at least we know that it will be noticeable in Chromium browsers. So my most sincere congratulations to the entire Flutter team and its contributors for having made this excellent work. If you want to see more performance tests and comparisons between Flutter 2 and Flutter 3, do not hesitate to subscribe to this channel, since I plan to carry out more experiments like this to be able to evaluate the impact that will have updating our applications to Flutter 3. If you liked this video, please give it a like. And if you want to see more content related to Flutter, here I leave you a recommendation. Thank you for watching, and have a great rest of your day.